Thanks for joining to the second webinar of the series which we have started 2 weeks back. So as you all know that today's topic for the webinar is decoding communication design, and to share about the topic we have with us is Professor Hashim Padiyarji. Sir has done MDes in visual communication from IIT Bombay. And prior to Anand University, he was with MIT Institute of Design in Pune. Over to you, Hashim, sir.
Hi. Thank you, Abhishek. Well, warm welcome to you all, to Anand. I'm sure you'll be, this is your second exposure probably to design disciplines. I'm going to give you a brief introduction to the communication design discipline, because I've been handling that for since its inception. You know, Anand started his communication design program last year. So we have the first batch getting into semester four. Yeah, semester four is over now, semester five. Second batch going to join in soon. So at Anand, you know, we have started the communication design program in such a way that, you know, students get a good exposure to all aspects of communication design, including graphic design, animation design, film and video design, as well as interaction design. Additionally, we also give electives in new media design, exhibition design, and more, which gives you an all-rounded view of communication design. Many of the schools offer just graphic design alone, but we have a complete communication design program, so which gives you a wide variety of areas to choose from. Okay, so I have a brief presentation arranged for you, so I'll just walk you through that.
Yes, sir.
Great. So communication design at Anand, I'm going to give you a brief idea about the concept, the curriculum, and the career prospects of communication design once you complete it at Anand. So, you know, basically the idea is that you cannot not communicate. You know, every one of us, whether we are doing any work, we have to communicate. We use language, we use graphics, we use signs to communicate with each other. If you want to express something, if you want to say something to somebody else, you know, we often use symbols, signs, and also graphics. You know? And so communication design is all about how graphics can be used to communicate better. You know, you can't always express things through words or signs. You need, you know, posters, you need books, you need websites, you need films, and all those things to communicate things to each other. So that is the basic premise of the program of communication design. So if you look at it, basically it's like the communication design is a creative visual arts discipline that combines text, image, and layout for print, electronic, or other media. So that really puts everything into perspective. It's not just about print. We're not just dealing with newspapers or magazines or advertisements or anything. We're also concerned about electronic media, that is short films, motion graphics, and, you know, the new upcoming media like, you know, webs, apps, and more. Even new media stuff like virtual reality, augmented reality, and mixed reality. So it's a big, vast area to explore. And it imposes order and structure to facilitate and ease the communication process. So what a communication designer does is, you know, he or she creates an order and creates a structure, so that, you know, the communicated message is clear to the end user. So that is the process of communication design. So it's one of the most in-demand classic design disciplines, which is expanded from print-based graphic design and includes, you know, animation, film and video, and interaction design in its fold. So earlier, you know, when communication design came in, it was purely graphic design. So that is mostly print-based design. So you are bringing out books, you are doing advertisements, you're doing newspapers, you're doing, you know, posters and those logos and stuff like that. But over time, you know, the field became larger and larger, started including animation in it, it's moving images, film and video in it, because, you know, we can communicate more using these media. And almost in 90s or late 90s, you know, interaction design came into its fold when websites came into being. And now apps are coming, and now, you know, multimedia and virtual reality, augmented reality has come into its fold. And also, I'm sure, you know, in years to come, it will also include the new subjects like that what we mentioned right now, virtual reality, augmented reality, and mixed reality, and whatnot, you know, more. So the field is ever expanding. So there's no stopping. So we have a well thought out curriculum that is, you know, being implemented in Anand. And of course, it's like any other curriculum, it's constantly being updated, getting feedback from students, industry, other faculty and all. So the syllabus is subject to change, but I'm going to present to you what we offer currently to students at Anand. So in semester one and two, we have foundation, you know. Foundation is common across all disciplines, whether you're an architecture student, you're a product design student, or interaction design student, or space design, or fashion, or communication, you have a same foundation. So in foundation, you learn the basics of, you know, visual thinking, illustrations, geometry, you know, verbal communication, and history of art and design and stuff like that. So that really prepares you for the more intense courses in the next few semesters. Starting from 3, 4, and 5 semesters, you are going to learn the basics of the discipline. So communication design requires some skill in typography, some skills in photography, some skills in videography. So these are all given to you in the semesters 3, 4, and 5. And in 6 and 7 semesters, you know, you're going to specialize in your area of interest. Not everyone is interested in, you know, doing newspapers or doing animation. So even though you're all exposed to these disciplines in the beginning, you can pick and choose your area of specialization through electives, projects, and research paper, and choose that as your final specialization. So that's what happens in the communication design program in 6 and 7 semesters. And finally, in the last semester, you have an entire semester devoted to a project. The project can be self-initiated, can be faculty initiated, or it can be industry sponsored also. So you got a wide variety of things to do in communication design. Now looking at semester 3, that's where, you know, you finish your foundation and join communication design. You have some interesting courses aligned. Basically, we start off with visual design course, that is a print software course. So you learn Adobe Illustrator, you learn Adobe Photoshop and Adobe InDesign to be ready with, you know, all print based requirements. Side by side, we also learn, you know, how to use basic typography, how to use proper fonts in everyday use. It's more of, you know, we are focusing more on application, usage of type. So basically in English rather, and of course with some exposure to vernacular scripts as well. Also, we give you some introduction to photography, that's basics of photography, you know, how to use a DSLR camera. What is shutter speed? What is, you know, focal length and many such things, film speed and all the iterations. So you will have little exercises which will, you know, advance gradually and you end up doing some amazing photography work in black and white and color as well. Simultaneously, we're also having some theory courses which include a design process. I mean, every design goes through a particular process. So that process is explained to you clearly, and you have some small projects which gives you an opportunity to apply this process in real life. Then, hi, Amitabh sir. Then we have a history of graphic design, which gives you a ringside view of, you know, graphic design's history, right from the caveman to, you know, through to, Gutenberg's, you know, a Bible, through printing, through video, through animation, through filmmaking, through virtual reality, and, you know, to the present day. That's a long process. Even though, you know, in the subsequent courses, you'll be introduced briefly to history of all these courses, we will be focusing it on in a holistic manner. Have a course in color theory, where, you know, you get to know how color can be used intelligently in your design solutions. So you get to know, you know, how Newton has approached color, Albier has approached color, you know, Goethe has approached color, and how do you look at color in a scientific as well as aesthetic way, and how to use it optimally in your assignments and projects. So that is all that happens in semester 3. So moving on, you reach semester 4, where, you know, you get to know video design software through Visual Design 2 course, where, you know, you'll be mostly doing, you'll be learning Adobe Premiere. You'll also be doing audition and stuff like that. So you get to know how to make a film, short film, entirely on your own. You know, at Anand, we believe in learning by doing. So when you're doing a film, you're going to do it from entirely from scripting to, you know, editing to photography to mixing and special effects and everything. So that is the basics that you learn in semester four. Along with that, we also learn semiotics. Semiotics is an interesting subject which gives you a good idea of, you know, how signs and symbols can be used to ease our communication. So that's one of the theory courses. So is a course called Communication Theory, which again gives you an idea of, you know, how this theory can help you, you know, decode many advertisements and movies and, you know, many kind of communication programs, you know. So there is some hidden theory underneath all these. So that's what you want to learn in Communication Theory course. And we have a course in Identity Design, which basically has a logo design and identity design, you know, and also making a brand book, you know, brand manual or something. So you'll be exposed to logos across the world. And you also come to know about a lot of logo designers, and you'll be given a project, you know, where you can start from scratch and create an identity of your own. And then you'll extend that to identity elements like stationery, other, you know, collaterals. And finally, you put them all together in a brand manual. So that's how the identity program unrolls. And building upon the photography course that we had in previous semester, that is basic photography. In this semester, we are looking at advanced photography, where, you know, you're learning about studio lighting and some extended effects in photography, you know, how to use special effects and all those things, editing as well. So that's what we learn in advanced photography. And we also have a brief exposure into motion graphics. Now, motion graphics is very interesting in the sense that it's the launching app, you know, into animation rather. So here you'll be animating graphics, pictures, logos and all, and create some interesting short films with some social message. So this could be used for film titling, you know, end credits, and can also be used on its own to create some interesting videos. So that sums up semester four. So moving on to semester five, you know, you're getting, you have been exposed to basic print and basic video. Now you're getting into the details of it. So here we're going to look at the printing technology part and the print and production methods, which is again a theory course. So here you're going to get exposed to all various kinds of printing, like screen printing, offset printing, digital printing, rotogravure, you know, special effects, post-press, pre-press. It's a vast field, you know, the kind of effects that you can really get through proper printing and choosing the right kind of material to print on. So based on that knowledge, you know, we'll be also applying that to publication design. In publication design, we'll be designing books, magazines, newspapers, and, you know, a lot of other collaterals. So that gives you a complete idea of, you know, how you can plan a book, how to, you know, lay it out, and, you know, how to get it printed as well. So these two courses, printed production methods and publication design, really equips you to be, you know, industry ready in publication design. And then we're also going to expose you to interaction design, which is one of the areas where, you know, many of the communication designers end up working in, because there are more opportunities and there are more avenues to express yourself in that particular field as of now. So we give you a brief exposure to interaction design in semester four. So you'll get to know what is UI, what is UX, and how do you plan an interface of a website or an app or something through hands-on exercises. Then we also have an interesting course called Design for Social Impact. So that is where, you know, whatever you learned till now, the print skills, your video skills, your animation skills can be put to use for a concerted campaign. Now, you know, you pick up some subject like, you know, child labor or something, or even, you know, LGBTQ or something, and you create a complete campaign right from print. So you make a newspaper ad, and you make a video ad or something, a film or something, or website promos or something. So all that is into one integrated social media campaign. You know? So that's what we're trying to explore in that. And also now we're getting into environmental graphics, because print is not just limited to books and paper or anything. There is a huge area of graphics, you know, that comes all around you. Signage, basically, and environmental graphics you see in malls and supermarkets and, you know, railway stations and airports and all. So you'll be working on some projects to get yourself acquainted with the vast area of environmental graphics. Then for anybody who's interested in specializing in typography, we also offer advanced typography course. There, you know, you're going to create typeface of your own. So you can create your own typefaces. I'm sure all of you have seen Helvetica and Times Roman and all, you know, so they've been created by somebody. So similarly, if you have some interesting ideas, you know, you can start creating your own typefaces through this course. So the fonts doesn't just include English, it can be vernacular, it can be symbols. So all that can be included in advanced typography course. So then, you know, you're getting into more advanced levels now. You are almost mastered the basic skills of communication design till semester 5. Now you're getting into professional practice and, you know, advanced concepts. Now you have a theory course called Professional Practice and Design Management. This gives you a good idea of, you know, how to use all these that you learned in all these semesters and create your own professional practice. So how do you charge for a design work? You know, what are the procedure involved in, you know, registering your firm? How do you apply GST to your billing? So these are all included in this course. You know? So that will help you be an entrepreneur, or even, you know, when you're working with a company, you know, how to, you know, monetize your work. That's what we are going to learn in professional practice and design management. We'll be having a lot of guests coming in who are practicing designers. We'll give you some ideas about, you know, how they use these techniques in real life. Then moving further, then we're also going to learn about data visualization, which is an important field that is fast emerging. You'll be learning how to, you know, create static as well as dynamic visualizations for selected subjects, you know. So that's an interesting area which has a lot of potential nowadays. You see a lot of graphics on TV screens, on, you know, webs and all, you know. So instead of reading long text, you know, it can be summarized in an amazing, attractive visualization. That's what you would learn in data visualization. And yes, another special niche area where, you know, both the product design and communication design merges is packaging design, you know, because we all purchase products on a daily basis. You know, we look at the packaging. That's a first interface between the product and you. So packaging has a huge potential, and communication design can really help you, you know, make the packaging look attractive and effective as well as, you know, informative as well. So that's what you're going to learn. So packaging can be just sachets, can be plastic covers, can be cartons, you know, can be molded ones also. So you're going to see the entire gamut of packaging in this course. Then again, you're getting into basic animation, you know. So here you're going to make a short animation film. We haven't started this course yet, so it could be cell animation that's done manually, or it could be a digital animation, which you do it on software. So this gives you a good introduction to animation. And people who are hooked to animation can explore it further in the coming semesters. And we also have a course called Visual Ergonomics. You know, it's a slightly scientific thing. You know, what is the right point size, or what is the right size a signage should be, or what distance should you keep a poster to make it look as, you know, legible to you? What is legibility? What is readability? So all these aspects are covered in this slightly scientific concept called Visual Ergonomics. Then, you know, after semester 6, you're getting into the industry. You go for a summer internship in the industry. You'll be spending 4 to 8 weeks, that's roughly, you know, 1 to 2 months in the industry. So we help you choose some of the firms, or you can choose your own and, you know, work there and get some hands-on knowledge, you know, how the industry works. And on coming back, you'll give us a presentation of your learnings and whatever you produce in that short internship period. Then comes the semester 7. Now you're getting a little bit more serious. You're being exposed to most of these areas. Now you're going to choose a subject and, you know, start writing a research paper on it. So there, you know, you could really explore, you know, some of the areas which has always been fascinating to you. Like, for instance, you might be interested in, you know, how Amar Chitrakatha has played a role in your upbringing, you know. So why not? So write a research paper on that. Or you think, you know, vernacular signboards are essential in a multilingual country like India. So then you're going to show it as examples in a research paper. So that's what happens in the research paper, which can be, the topic can be selected by the student, or even the faculty can be help you choose one of their liking. Then we also learn about system thinking. That's a very interesting field where, you know, you would apply many of your allied learning into one field. Many of the design problems are not very simple, so they get complex. So you need to apply, you know, more than a design skills. You know, you have to get some management inputs, you have to get some planning inputs and that. So system thinking really makes you, you know, work in a team and work with other professionals in complex problems. You know, so it's not just a one-man show. It's all, many of these design problems are solved as a team. So that's what you learn in system thinking. Then Anant is about all sustainability and, you know, environmental friendliness. So we have also included a course called Sustainable Graphic Design, which gives you ways and means of, you know, making your practice, you know, eco-friendly. How to avoid wastages? What are the techniques to use to reduce paper usage? You know, how you can create a packaging which doesn't have a carbon footprint? You know, so these things you learn in sustainable graphic design. And we also get to handle a signage and a wayfinding project. It could be for a mall, it could be for a city even. You know, you're going to create signboards and wayfinding graphics for the entire place. And you've already acquired skills in videography and stuff. So now we're going to get into short film making. So here we'll help you with writing a script, you know, visualizing it, shooting it, editing it, and putting it together as a film with even the final color correction. So you make a short documentary or a short even fiction film as well. So that's what you learn. And anybody who's interested in pursuing that further can, you know, even specialize that in that in your with your project. So then we also expose you to the new medias, you know, as I said before, you know, the graphic design field is huge. It's getting, you know, more and more interesting year by year. So you'll be exposed to practitioners from, you know, virtual reality and immersive media. It's like, you know, augmented reality as well as mixed reality. And you'll get to know how this can be put effectively in your projects. That's how the syllabus is planned till semester 7. And with all these learnings, you know, you're going to get into semester 8 where you're doing a graduation project. So it's basically, you know, it could be a self-initiated project. You might want to do something badly for yourself, or you think there's a serious lacuna in the industry and you want to solve it. Yes. And it could also be an industry-sponsored project. And Anant might have got some inquiries regarding a certain project. So we'll be happy to share that with you as a project for you. Or even faculty could suggest some interesting projects depending on the, you know, every student's capabilities. So it could be of any of these. So that's how we have planned the 8 semesters in Anant. So that gives you, you know, the whole 4-year curriculum in a nutshell. But as I said again, you know, there are a lot of other things added to it. One is, you know, beyond the syllabus, we'll be having industry visits, expert talks, and workshops. So because the pandemic has been raging for the last 1 year, we haven't been able to do much on this front, but I hope while you're back on the campus, you know, we'll be having more regular industry visits. We'll have more expert talks who are practicing for designers. We'll give you some, you know, insights into their way of working. We'll also have some workshops of experts, you know, who gives you something about a short 2 or 3 day workshop on, you know, calligraphy or, you know, raku pottery or something like that, which we plan to organize. Then we also have a list of electives. Every semester you can choose one elective, and, you know, that will give you a kind of exposure to many other fields also. So even if you're a product designer or a communication designer, you know, you can even think of doing some additional work in 3D graphics or game design or exhibition design. So electives are the right way of doing it. So we plan to offer electives in printmaking. We had one in calligraphy, paper making also we had. Travel photography also we plan to do. Mural painting, creative coding, you know, where you'll be learning processing and some little bit of programming. Then we also have Internet of Things, which is quite a hip thing nowadays, you know, how we can program everything, you know, and make them all sync with your computer or your intelligent devices. There could be even a theater workshop where you'll be making a play, writing a play, directing a play, and staging it also. Folk art, India has so many interesting variations in folk art. So you'll be exposed to that through small exercises. You could be creating your own graphic novels under some expert guidance. You'll be learning some basics of web, you know, programming. We had this elective in the last semester. You'll be exposed to, you know, how to see, watch a film and appreciate it and, you know, analyze it properly. And you could also, if you are interested in larger spaces and things, you know, exhibition design could be a good option for you. And if you want to really, you're into computer gaming and all, you can try your hand at game design as well. And yes, if you like to play around with 3D graphics, you know, we have a course in that as well. So these are the electives. Again, these are list, you know, can be changed, but depending on the availability of faculty and also depending on the availability of students, you know. So that's how electives have been planned. So I would like to point out that, you know, even though communication design is a single course, we have certain focus areas. So you can focus on graphic design, you can focus on interaction design, you can focus on animation design, or you could even do for video and film design as well. But you can also specialize in photography if you are really keen on photography. There could be people who are really keen on illustration, then you can even specialize in that. So give you so much options in within communication design to focus on. And in graphic design, you know, you have three, you have courses in typography in semester three, photography in semester three and four, identity design in four, publication design in semester five, packaging design in six, 3D graphics as an elective and type design as an elective. So that gives you an all-rounded view of it to practice as a full-fledged graphic designer. But if you are keen on photography, we have two courses, basic photography and advanced photography. But your publication design skills and other skills can also help you, you know, put your photography into a publishing format. And somebody who has an interest in animation design, yeah, we don't offer full-fledged animation design course. But if you are really keen, you can specialize, choose these electives and, you know, specialize in that. So semester four, we have motion graphics. We expose students to basic animation in semester six. We have an elective in sound design and advanced animation is also an elective later. So that gives you a good exposure to animation and you can work on that, you know, as a full-fledged animator. Interaction design, even though Anant has a full-fledged interaction design discipline, well, industry requires, you know, people with multiple skills, you know, so there is a good demand for people with a communication design background with added interaction design skills. So we're going to offer you interaction design exposure in semester five and advanced interaction design course in elective. And you can also have an elective in game design and immersive media design, which will enhance your interaction design skills. And yes, some people have, you know, really want to get into filmmaking once they start getting into, you know, video and other software. So we have scores in motion graphics, we have sound design elective, short filmmaking, and VFX elective also being offered later. So we have some interesting faculty. We have resident faculty from, you know, reputed art and design schools. And we have visiting faculty also from these schools like NID, IDC, you know, Srishti and many other design schools from India and abroad. We also bring in a lot of practicing designers from industry to give you a hands-on, you know, exposure to the courses in Anand. Yeah, so, you know, yes, got a little delay in my. You know, in to do a course in communication design, you know, you're expected to have a well-configured laptop, at least 16 GB RAM, 1 TB hard disk, and a graphics card. And you're also be using Adobe Creative Cloud as a software. So you can either license it or Anand has some schemes to give you software at a discounted rate. And you'll also need a DSLR or a mirrorless digital camera for you with a good resolution with some basic lenses. You can always keep adding lenses. Anand will have, we don't have it right now, have a full-fledged photo lab and print lab and all. So they'll be having lenses and cameras. So you can also take them on loan if you want to explore things. Yeah. So now, you know, we have this, what all that I spoke about was about the communication design major. So that's a four-year program, you know, you completely practicing in that. But we, Anant also offers a minor programs, you know. So this helps you have an exposure to one or the other design discipline, but not completely, only for four semesters. So we offer communication design, department offers a graphic design minor. So that will be only about print and, you know, that runs across semesters 3 to 6. So this includes two courses in each semester and this happens on Wednesdays. So if you're doing communication design, there's no point doing graphic design minor. You could take up something in, you know, fashion design or product design or, you know, interaction design, or that will really enhance your skills. So in the minor program, what we have is in semester three, we have visual design and typography. In semester four, we have semiotics and identity design. And in semester five, data visualization, publication design. And semester six, we have packaging design, signage, and wayfinding design. So that gives you a short abridged version of the entire communication design program. So even if you're interested in product design, you know, you could really pursue, and if you have some interest in graphics, you could actually do it as a minor as well. But it won't give you an entire picture of the program, but it will give you an edited version of the program, communication design. Yeah. And yeah, what are the opportunities, you know, in the industry? That's what everyone will be interested in. You know, in fact, you know, communication designers are actually one of the most sought after specialists in the industry, because every, you know, as I said, you cannot not communicate. So communication designers in corporates are quite in demand. In design studios, they want extra hands. And, you know, interaction visual designers in IT companies and the print designers in publishing houses, visual designers in advertising agencies, animator in animation studios, filmmaker in ad filmmaking studios. And finally, there's an option of teaching as well. So you can also be self-employed, you know. Many of us, you know, actually choose to be on their own. So you can be an entrepreneur, you can be professional photographers, you can be illustrators, you can be type designers, you can be freelancers, you know. So you have to pitch for projects and, you know, do it on a freelance basis, you know. That some people like that. They don't want to get, you know, attached to an, you know, some firm or something. They want to be free. So that's also a possibility. So you can also think of further studies. What we would suggest is, you know, master of design in graphic design, animation design, film and video design, interaction design, and immersive media design, because we offer a university recognized course, so you can always apply it to, you know, any major institute in the country or abroad also. And you can also think of doing a PG in design management as well. That's also an interesting area. It's fast emerging. And if you're really keen on, you know, after that, you can also think of doing a PhD in design. So that's about it, the program. Any questions?
Sir, we'll take the questions after Amitabh sir's presentation.
Yeah.
All the attendees, if you have any question, we have a Q&A section. You can start writing your questions in the Q&A section. Right. Now I would like to welcome Amitabh sir. Amitabh sir has done his master's in communication design from NID Ahmedabad and has a technical experience of 24 years in the field of communication design. Welcome Amitabh sir, and over to you sir.
First of all, Abhishek, I don't have any presentation. I think Hashim's presentation was quite comprehensive, and that gave a complete idea of the entire communication department of Ananta University. I'll just say a few words about the communication design field and what you really need to have it in you if you really want to become successful communication designer, or if you want to pursue communication design. One thing, when Professor Hashim showed the prerequisite of where you have stationaries, cameras, and laptops, and everything else, I would, with Hashim sir's permission, I will like to add one soft skill, which is not the hardware, but the software, that you need to have passion. Everything will come, but you really need to have passion. If you are passionate about this, you will find your own ways of doing it. Right. Second thing is that there's a saying in Bangla, but I'm not a Bengali, so I don't know exact wordings in Bangla, but the English translation is that if your passion becomes your profession, that's the ultimate. So there's nothing like it. So that's what you are going to do. If you are really passionate, this is the place. And whatever you want to do, there are a lot of dreams when we were in plus two stage, or when we were thinking about the career choices. So like many fellow friends of mine, I opted for something which I was really passionate about. And because I opted something which I was really passionate about, it never gave me any stress. I really enjoyed every day working with projects, attending classes, and doing whatever I really wanted to do. One more thing which I think none like other courses or other university, they will not be able to offer you. Here you are, you know, you're getting one environment where you, you know, one thing which you need to understand, that design never happens in isolation. So it's not that you are just learning communication design. You are living where you are staying in a campus where your fellow classmate or roommate is from product design, seniors are doing interactive design. You also have a school of architecture. So you are learning in an environment where everybody is you know, doing something very creative. So you learn from all of them. So learning is not just in classroom, but in the entire campus where you have, sir, correct me if I'm wrong, 600 plus or how many students at a time in the campus. So that's simply wonderful, like learning with so many students and all of them are, you know, into the creative field. So this is something very fabulous, which happens at Anand, because you also have architecture, School of Architecture together. So, and when it comes to career opportunities, I feel Professor Hashim has really put everything so nicely. The last section was that you become entrepreneur, you become your like a freelancer doing whatever you want to do. And it happens in most of our careers. Sometimes after doing your own work, you want to do something on your own. And this gives you a lot of good opportunity and experience when you are you have gone through this course. One last thing which I would like to add, that the syllabus, the course is designed in such a manner that you are learning everything of communication design, and that's really wonderful. So that when you go for your master's after doing this 4 years, where you are becoming generalist, you know everything, you know, you learn type design, you also know filmmaking, you know the basics of animation, everything you know. So that gives you, that makes a very good grounding. And now you are prepared to do your specialization if you want in the master's, then you can select one. So because industries, when you go and join, design is, as I've told earlier, it's not, it doesn't happen in isolation. So you have very good idea, you have experience of working in all the areas. So that will make you a complete designer. In some institutes, this and universities, this is not the system. Here you learn everything and then you do masters. That's really wonderful about this course. Yes, Abhishek, if you if they want to ask question.
Yes, sir, we have few questions. The first question is, can you please explain the web basics briefly?
Yeah, sure. Now, what happens is, you know, because if you want to make a website, you can do it from HTML, you can do your own hand coding, and you can do things very simply. You don't have to use all these, you know, fancy Wix or applications or something that's commonly available. So you can do hand coding. So that web basic course gives you a hands-on experience of, you know, how to create your own website using Notepad and basic HTML and, you know, Flash or CSS script or something. So that's a very basic course. We have it as an elective in the first few years.
Second question, can you please repeat the prerequisite required for the course?
Yeah, as Amitabh sir rightly said, you know, the prerequisite is passion. You know, it's a passion to create something new, something interesting. That's the main thing. Other than that, you know, hardware is required, because we are doing everything by computers nowadays. You know, when I was the learning design, we used to cut and paste, use rubber solution and all those things. But now, you know, things are all completely digital. You just need a laptop to do everything, you know. So you need a good laptop with some 16 GB RAM, some 1 TB hard disk to save your files, and a graphics card, because you'll be doing some video editing as well. So that's your hardware requirement for computer. And you need a DSLR camera or a mirrorless camera, whichever you choose. And it should be at least 24 MP something. So you can also shoot video on it. And you need some basic lenses. Basically, a minimum zoom will do for all your work. And the lab, photo lab, will have some extra lenses to share also. So that will be quite handy for you. Also, you'll be using Adobe software. So you can purchase it off your own. You can. We have some programs where you can license it to you at a cheaper rate, at a school rate. So that's also possible. So these are the four requisites that you have from a student.
I just would like to add one thing. Like when we talk about camera is something which they can plan after joining Anant. So they don't need to buy camera and come to Anant or start course. Don't you think so? Yeah, because
that's right.
They can discuss with their faculty members, those who teach photography, and then they can plan to which camera will be most suitable of that.
That's right. Absolutely right. You know, because these things, hardware things, they get extinct very fast, So it's always wise to buy it at the last moment.
Yes.
So you need a camera only in semester three. So you can postpone it till semester three. Okay. But I guess laptop is required when you join. Yeah. So that you may have to have it right in the beginning. But when you invest in a laptop, make sure that it is, future proof, at least for 4 years, it serves your purpose. Yep.
One of the questions is, can you give us an idea about the average package for a student communication design at Anant and in general also?
Yeah, Anant design program has started only 2 years back. So we don't have any, graduates coming out of Anant yet. So we are not sure, what are the payment packages or what are the placement. But we'll have a placement cell. We will be helping you find placement in the industry. And we'll also arrange internships and all those things. So rest assured that, you will have good options to choose from when you graduate out of Anant.
Can you again explain about minor specialization, when to opt for this?
Oh, that's interesting, because what happens is, when we might have some preconceived notion, that I want to be a product designer. But I come to Anant and go through the foundation year, and I might feel that, I have a good hand in illustration. So why can't I do graphic design or communication design? But you're actually in between two worlds, So you want to do this and do as well as do the other one. So to avoid that confusion, what we've done is we give you a specialization. That's your major. So you choose product design as your major, and you can take graphic design as your, minor program. So, you get the best of both worlds. You can have a specialization in your major while you get an exposure to the minor as well. And you select the minor by semester three. So by semester three, you have to make up what is your major and what is your secondary interest. That becomes your minor.
Will there be session for other themes like product, fashion? I don't know. I couldn't understand the question.
Yeah, they're asking, now we had a session for product design earlier, I guess. And this is about
communication. So we, as I said in the previous session also, that we are doing a series of webinars and workshops for you, wherein till now we have done one webinar and one workshop. This is the second webinar. We are coming up with a product design workshop next Friday. I will be sharing the details on the WhatsApp like I'm doing from last 2 weeks, and you will receive a mail as well. And each and every specialization which Anant National University is offering, we will be coming up with a session for that as well. Can we go for double major at Anant U?
Yeah, that's an interesting question. We don't have it right now. We just started the minor program last semester. So this has to work out, So you'll have to have one major and a minor, not two majors.
So I think they might be talking about the transdisciplinary design we are offering.
Yeah, probably that might be interesting. Yeah, we also have a program called transdisciplinary design, where you can join that discipline and pick and choose courses from each discipline. So I can choose one or two courses from interaction design. I can choose one or two from graphic design, and make your own menu of program. So that is all. That option also there, but we don't have a double major as such. We have a major and a minor.
I will be pursuing product design. Should I buy a laptop of Windows software or Apple software?
That is entirely your choice, you know, because Windows machines are, you know, you got a lot of configurations and a lot of options are there. But if you go for Apple, it's very expensive and the options are very less. We have some fixed configurations. If you can afford, you can surely go for an Apple. Otherwise, even Windows are very well configured machines nowadays.
The next question is, if I take communication as minor, do I need the same device and same software as major course?
Yes, you know, because if you want to do communication design, you have to have a basic Adobe design software like Illustrator, InDesign, and you know, Photoshop. Yes, you have to have the same as major.
Alak is asking, do Anand offer BDES in UI and UX?
Yeah, we have a complete BDES discipline in interaction design that covers UI and UX.
Sir, as mentioned by you, I agree design cannot be learned in isolation. As a parent, I am very concerned about the online modality.
Yeah, you know, we're all concerned about it, but we don't have a choice right now, you know. Since last 1 year, since last March, we have gone online. And all courses, you know, have been conducted online. Yeah, there are some handicaps, definitely. But we are trying our best to, you know, do the best in the current situation. And we plan to supplement these courses with hands-on supplementary courses when the campus reopens.
I'll just add, Professor Hashim, to what Mr. Hriday Pathak is saying. I agree, and he's saying that he agrees to when I say the design cannot happen in isolation. But I also see this lockdown as blessing in disguise. What's happening right now, when suppose there's a class of a batch of 40 students and we are learning identity design. I'm giving you my example because right now I'm taking identity design with the students. So in the classroom situation, what happens when you talk to or when you give feedback to a particular student, you are only focusing to him or her. So you may be going to her table or talking to that, or maybe in a group of two or three. But here, each one is learning because we are all online and we are all sharing our screens and showing their work. So everybody is learning from each other's work. So that is something which is very good, which is happening. Second, that we are also getting opportunities of interacting with other experts, which was not actually possible, which is only possible when you are on online. So there are some benefits too. And I am realizing that, you know, there are some things which are blessing in disguise, where students are getting to see each other's work very closely. And they are also listening to the feedback for everyone. And that also is adding to their learning. Yeah.
Hashim said, during your presentation, there was one question that was asked, which I said that I will take later on. The student wants to know about folk art. I think it was in your presentation. So right, they want to know more about folk art.
That's right. You know, there are some students who are interested in illustrations and, you know, the graphical traditions of the country, you know, because every region has its own beautiful folk art. Like, for instance, you have Warli in Maharashtra, you have Gond in tribal areas, you know, you got Madhubani. There is Patchitra in Orissa, you know, there's so many things, you know. So we have an elective which exposes you to this folk art and it helps you create your own folk art. This could be handy to you when you're making a book illustration or a project, and you could use it as your source material, you know.
I'll also add one more thing, that it will also help them when they do design for social impact. So right. If they know about their culture, their art, because the kind of subject in social impact, my experience for the audience, I would like to say that I have spent almost around 25 years in the field working for social design, for social impact, for communication, for behavior change. So there, when you are working in the field, working in the villages, working for the people, you need to work with their mediums, their vocabulary. So that way, all these things, especially folk art, if you have knowledge of your culture, tradition, if you have deep knowledge of folk art, that really works. And there are many things which we do, taking help or taking some reference from folk art.
So the next question is, which brand is recommended in current scenario, either communication design or UI UX design?
That's interesting. And you know, that entirely depends on your interest, you know, because basically some people have a knack for communication design. They want to make the films, they want to make take photography, they want to make illustration, they want to produce books, you know. So then, of course, go for communication design. But if you really want to do only interfaces and games and, you know, screen-based stuff, you know, you don't have to waste your time doing communication design. So you don't have to learn how to make logos or how to make signage or, you know, how to make take photographs and all. So that's an entirely different field. So it depends on your aptitude, you know, what you really want to do. If you like UI UX, go for it. But if you want to have a, you know, more traditional approach to design, you know, communication design gives you a wider variety.
How Anand will help in masters from abroad?
This is something that I may not be able to help you, but I can assure you that, you know, Anand has some associations with some universities abroad. So we could probably help you, you know, find placements or, you know, find scholarships and all those things. Yeah.
But so I think Anand has some foreign university tie-up for student exchange as well as for the curriculum exchange. Major, minor courses you have already explained. Do we have integrated courses? No, we don't have any integrated courses.
Yeah, we have, sir. Yeah, we have. You know, we have an integrated course, a master's in integrated product design, you know, and we also MUDD, master's in urban design and development. So that's a, you know, 5-year program. So what you do is you complete the almost a BDS program and then, you know, spend one more extra year to get your master's. So you get a BDS as well as an MDS. So you save 1 year from.
Okay.
But it hasn't really taken off well. But yeah, I guess in the future, it will be a much sought after course. Yeah.
What is the scope of 2D animation design in India?
Yeah, that's an interesting question. You know, like the other day, I was actually speaking to somebody, you know, like there's a lot of scope for animation nowadays. You know, there's a lot of motion graphics and television channels, on websites, on films and everywhere, you know, people are looking at things, you know, because they don't have time to read things. So if you can communicate the, you know, ideas about COVID and precautions and, you know, protocols and all through animation and stuff, you know, it's easier. Everybody can understand, irrespective of language, you know. So I guess the options of animation is ever on increase. In fact, abroad and all, you know, even the traffic signs, the hoardings are all animated. So it really is a very upcoming area, you know. Yeah.
Could you recommend some laptops? Sir has already said that I think once they join immediately, they can interact with the faculty,
right,
to know more. I want to pursue product design. Do I need a 16 GB RAM laptop?
Well, you know, not necessary. Even 4 GB will do, 8 GB will do, you know, but you know, Windows recommends 8 GB a minimum and 16 GB as recommended, you know. So I would recommend 16 GB because you'll be using some heavy software, you know, 3D modeling stuff and, you know, Rhino and all those things, 3D Studio or something that requires some RAM. So
sir,
I would
still be asking for product design. I want to pursue product design. That also requires 16 GB laptop.
I would recommend that. But okay, you can always start with 8 GB and upgrade it if it's not a Mac. Mac, you can't upgrade. If it's a Windows PC, you can always upgrade. So you can start with 8 GB, and if you think it's not sufficient, you can go for a upgrade.
Okay, so the question, Khushi is repeating what Mr. Patek has asked, how we'll be able to cope without actually coming to the college with online be as effective?
That is a, you know, we're all concerned about that. Yeah, I agree, you lose some fun, but as Amitabh sir rightly said, you know, it's a mixed blessing, you know. There are some things you lose out, but some things you gain through online thing. You can sit at home, have home cooked food, you know, you don't have to go out, and you can do more time to do your assignments and all, you know, and you can, yeah, so that's there. But you miss the fun of being in the campus and doing things, you know, in group or something. Yeah, that's.
Another student wants to know, if one doesn't have a good sketching, then what would be the what we do prior to the classes start.
Yeah, you know, yeah, sketching is an essential tool for any designer, whether it's interaction or communication or product, you know. So you could really start, sketching from, you know, real life objects, or you look up some books and try copy things, you know. You need to have a good hand to, you know, represent your ideas, you know, even if it's a complex idea or simple idea, you know, it's a very good tool to have sketching skills. So I would surely recommend that you guys should, you know, start sketching on a daily basis, do a few sketches. Maybe Amitabh sir can probably suggest better ways of doing
it. What I always tell my students, that don't postpone the idea. We all have a habit of procrastination. We think that, okay, kal karenge, parso karenge type. So always try to maintain a sketchbook, and wherever you are sitting, like right now, I am in front of this view, but still I have a pencil and the notebook with me, and I try drawing, you know, sometimes I draw the speakers when I'm listening to them. I also try, this was from one of the sessions. So I always do that. So you need to develop this habit that nothing, it is, if you'll start thinking in terms of that, okay, I'll devote this much of time, I'll do in the morning, it will never happen. Always keep a sketchbook or whatever paper that you have, and a pencil. Pencil is required. Maybe after some time you can graduate to pen or something, but start with a pencil, take a good pencil, any pencil, and start drawing. Whatever you see, you just draw. If you're not interested in what seeing and drawing, then you draw anything, you do your doodling. So that will also, you know, create interest in you. And then this is little on a personal side. I'll give you an example of somebody whom I know. Actually, she is my sister, 10 years elder than me. She, during the lockdown period, she is making every day for last 2 years, she every day before sleeping, she makes one watercolor drawing. Every day before sleeping, she sends me on my WhatsApp one painting of hers. So you need to develop that habit. And that if you think that nahi mere paas ek achha sketchbook hoga, ek badhiya wala pen hoga, tabhi kar payenge, nothing like that. You can start doing where you are sitting right now. You start, you make my caricature. I'm, you know, for last how many minutes, almost 1 hour we are sitting. So you make one caricature of mine and post it here. So it depends, you know, that's the way you learn.
Can interior designers major and graphic designers minor go along well?
Yeah,
if I have some interest in graphic design also.
We have some students who are doing exactly that, you know, they have taken space design as a major and doing graphic design on the side as a minor. Yeah, it's very well works.
Does UI UX need knowledge of programming languages?
Not necessarily, but it helps, you know, because again, it depends on the course being offered in the particular university. I think we have some courses in programming also. Yeah. So some introduction to programming skills can be helpful, but it's not essential. You can always pick it up.
I'm interested in communication design course. Am I expected to purchase the Adobe Creative Cloud software, or will I get from college?
That's an question. Yeah, you know, you can actually purchase it off your own, but as a student license, you know, it costs much less. And we have the institutional licensing program also, that's even more less. So I would recommend that you get the software, you know, if you want a legal version through us, you know, that will be much cheaper, almost half the price that you will be paying on your own as a student.
What is the duration of the elective?
Electives, yeah, that's interesting. Electives, you know, we have one elective, at least one elective per semester. So electives are normally conducted on Wednesdays for 2 hours for one whole semester. That's about 16 weeks. So that comes to around 32 hours completely. Yeah, you know, so that gives you a good exposure to the elective. Yeah.
Not really acquainted with the basics of illustrations and other related technical stuff. Will we learn from scratch for communication design?
Yes, you know, the foundation course really equips you with all the essential skills, you know. you will be, even if your doodling skills are not good or you're not exposed to certain styles or pen and ink or something, you know, you have a complete course in the first two semesters, which gives you a good exposure to illustration and, you know, a technical drawing like geometry and perspectives and all those things. So you can learn from scratch, but of course, aptitude and passion has to be there.
Patek sir, we are planning to start the session. Currently, it's planned in the month of August, though the dates are not finalized. What are the scope of interaction design in the market?
Of course, you know, I'm not an expert in interaction design, but I think the interaction design has one of the biggest scope currently, you know, because a lot of people are recruiting many product designers, communication designers, as well as interaction designers, you know, end up working in major IT companies because they pay more, probably. So
that has become first choice of many students when they pass out. Even I can tell you, Anushree, that even those who have done specialization in other fields, they also opt for interaction design and UI UX because that's that has a very, very big market. I've seen students, you know, of product design going for interaction design and doing UI UX because they have good knowledge of design in general and doing quite well. So there's a lot of scope. When you say scope, that means career opportunities and how much you earn from that. That's the scope. That's, you know, this word scope comes from there only. So there's a lot of scope.
Can you reselect an elective after the semester?
I'm sorry, can you?
Can you reselect an elective after the semester?
No. When you register for a semester, you know, you opt for an elective. So that elective stays with you for that semester. But in the next semester, you can opt for another elective.
The same elective can't be taken again?
No.
How can we be more creative and improve our observation skills?
Amitabh sir can probably explain that.
I always say that start questioning. If you'll start questioning, you'll improve your observation skill. See, this is a pencil and we write with this. But this has some function. Have we ever checked what is the function? Whether are we curious about looking at the function, how it really works, if this is you know, clutch pencil or something, or maybe the sanitizer bottle, how it actually works, how it functions, why it is like that, why the product is like that. So when you'll start questioning, you'll really understand the why part of it. And Mr. Einstein, I think he said very interesting thing that I think he said, if I'm not wrong, that curiosity with intelligence is equal to creativity. So something like that. So, you know, observation will also, I think, drawing really helps in observing things. None other tool will be, you know, as effective as drawing, because when you draw something, you spend time with that particular thing for hours, for minutes. So it will never happen in other things. So drawing and questioning, whatever you see, whatever you do, you must question. So these are the two things which I can tell you right now.
Last two questions. Can I take illustration as minor with product design as major? Is it a good idea?
Well, you know, we don't have illustration as a minor right now, but we may offer it in future. But right now, we don't have illustration. We have to take graphic design. That will have more of illustration.
So the last question which I have is, I haven't understood the major minor thing.
Yeah, I'll explain once more. See, as I said, you know, everyone has varied interests, you know. Like you might be interested in product design, but you have a soft corner for animation also. Or you might be interested in photography while you're interested in, you know, product design. But product design doesn't offer any course in photography. So that, you know, makes you think of, you know, why should I choose this over that, you know. So to avoid that confusion, what we have arranged is we got a major program, which is your main interest, product design. And the minor, which will be running across only four semesters, semester three to semester six, will be on a specified topic. Right now we have four or five minors, but the list of minors are increasing year by year. So you could have a minor on photography itself for the four semesters. So you have a good knowledge of photography as well as product design. So that helps you, you know, have the best of both worlds.
I think I have taken all the questions. Let me check the chat box.
I just want to say one thing.
Yes, sir.
I'm really impressed to see the kind of question the students and parents are asking. It is such a focused question. I have attended so many programs like that, but the kind of question this group is asking, students as well as parents, it is really, really, it shows that you are really serious about whatever you are planning to do. So I'm very happy to see the kind of question you are posting.
Now we have three more questions in last few seconds. My parents are concerned about placements because Anantyu is a young university. How do we be assured?
That is, yeah, sure. I mean, I do understand your concern. But, you know, being a young university also has its advantages, you know. You're also growing with the university. You will be the brand ambassadors, you know. There is some, already Anantyu has created some good impact in the industry with some interventions, you know. So you have an advantage. But if you are in an old university or something, you know, you'll just become one among the hundreds. So here you're going to, you know, cut your own path, you know. So that's an added advantage you have.
What will we get a degree for that? So Anant National University is a UGC approved university, which comes in the state private university category. So if you visit UGC website, there's a list of approved universities. There are four types of universities in India: central, state, private, and deemed to be university. So you go to the state private university list, and all the universities approved by UGC, you will find state-wise list, and you will find. So the degree, we are allowed to give the degree, the bachelor's and the master's degree. So the students registered for the BDES program will get, after the course completion of 4 years, they will get bachelor's of design degree. And the master's students will get master's of design as a degree. Can we take communication design as major, space design as minor, and also electives?
Well, you know, that's a, you know, yeah, we don't have space design as a minor as such. You know, we might be getting furniture design as a minor. So you can also have electives, definitely, but it'll increase your load, you know. So you'll be running between courses, and also that'll be a huge load. So if you have the aptitude and you can work hard, you know, why not take electives as well as a minor? Yeah, sure.
And the degree in the case of major minor. So degree would be the bachelor of design degree. So that's the degree. All the major minors and specializations you study would be under that. So if you're doing the major, I think, sir, if I'm not wrong, the major specialization would be mentioned in the degree.
Yeah.
So if the student is doing a communication design, it would be bachelor of design in communication design.
Yeah.
Does Anantyu offer diploma courses? No, currently we are not offering diploma courses. I hope all the questions are... So question related to product design, integrated product design, we will take in the next Friday workshop. So that is, the faculty would be from product design. And I think if we answer that time, that would be the right time. Will you get certificate for minor? I think there is no, I think it would be mentioned in the market, but it won't be, there won't be any separate certificate that would be issued. Interior designing, we'll have a separate session on space design where we'll take question of interior design. Okay, I think there's no more question left. Thank you so much, Harshan sir. Thank you so much, Abhitab sir, for taking out time and guiding this young design aspirant. I think the most question which I have received during when I interact with these students, some of them might have spoken to me. The major question comes for the communication design, and along with that, I learned a lot today on communication design, because I, again, I'm not from a design background. I'm from the admissions, but then I have very little knowledge about the design. I'm learning since last 1.5 years. Thank you so much for this wonderful session and insight about the course curriculum, the future prospect. I would like to thank all the attendees for joining in, and hope to see you soon at the campus, currently in a virtual mode, but would be very happy to see you all when the campus starts. Thank you so much.